हेलो एवरीवन, ओके, इन यूनिट 3 आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर इज मॉडल एनालिसिस. ओके, सो वी विल स्टार्ट विद मॉडल एनालिसिस. फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज मॉडल एंड प्रोटोटाइप. ओके, यू नो द डिज़ाइन, कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग ऑफ द वेरियस हाइड्रोलिक स्ट्रक्चर्स सच एज अ डैम, स्पिलवे और हाइड्रोलिक मशीन सच एज अ टर्बाइन, पम्प्स. ओके, दैट कैन नॉट बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड और इरेक्टेड डायरेक्टली फॉर इट्स फुल साइज. ओके, दे कैन नॉट बी कंस्ट्रक्टेड डायरेक्टली ऑफ इट्स ओरिजिनल लेंथ. ओके, सो दैट्स वाई वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट वन प्रोटोटाइप और मॉडल. ओके, विथ सेम फंक्शन, सेम डायमेंशन, बट इन लेस, व्हाट वी से, लेस साइज. ओके, बिफोर कंस्ट्रक्शन और मैन्युफैक्चरिंग एनी स्ट्रक्चर और मशीन, देयर मॉडल्स आर कंस्ट्रक्टेड एंड टेस्ट आर परफॉर्म्ड ऑन देम टू बी ऑब्टेन द डिजायर्ड इन्फॉर्मेशन. ओके, वॉट इज द मॉडल? द मॉडल इज द स्मॉल स्केल रेप्लिका ऑफ द एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर और द मशीन. ओके, इट इज अ स्मॉल स्केल रिप्लिका ऑफ द एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर और द मशीन. ओके, द एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर और द मशीन इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोटोटाइप. ओके, इट इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोटोटाइप. यू नो दैट द जनरली द मॉडल्स आर मच स्मॉलर देन द करस्पॉन्डिंग प्रोटोटाइप्स, बट इन सम केसेस मॉडल्स मे बी लार्जर देन द प्रोटोटाइप्स. ओके, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, द डैम और द स्पिलवे कैन बी स्टडीड इन स्मॉल स्केल, वेयर एज द वर्किंग ऑफ अ रिस्ट वॉच और द कार्बोरेटर्स कैन बी स्टडीड इन अ लार्ज स्केल मॉडल. ओके, ओके, बिफोर दैट, व्हाट आर द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ द मॉडल टेस्टिंग? सो यू नो द मॉडल टेस्ट आर क्वाइट इकोनॉमिकल एंड कन्वीनियंट. Model tests are quite economical and convenient for the safe design of any structure. Okay, it reduces the unnecessary expenditures of the actual structures, and it's still more suitable. Suitable design is obtained. Okay, for performance. Wait a minute. Okay, for performance of any hydraulic structure or the machines, it can be predicted in advance by using the model test. Okay. So the model testing can be used to detect and rectify the defects of an existing structures which is not functioning properly. Okay, okay, these are the advantages of the model testing. Okay, so what are the applications of the model testing? So the first application is that model testings are very important for the following fields. Like first one is the civil engineering structures such as the dams, spillways, weirs, canals, etc. to predict the working of full size structures. Okay, second one is the fluid control and irrigation channels. Then the third one is the design and development of the turbines, pumps and compressors. Then the design of the harbors, ships and submarines structures, also the aeroplane, rockets, missiles. Okay, also the skyscrapers or the high-rise buildings to predict the wind loads. Okay, wind loads, the stability characteristics of the airflow patterns. Okay, so these are some applications of the model testing. The next part of this unit is the SIS. Similitude and similarities or similarities. Okay, so what is the similitude? There are the three similitude types. One is the geometric, second one is the kinematic, and third one is the dynamic similarities. Okay, okay, the what is similitude? Similitude is defined as the similarities between the model and its prototype in every respect. Okay, the results obtained from the experiments or the models can be applied to the prototype only if a complete similarities exist between the model and the prototype. Okay, there are some scale ratio. The ratio, what is the scale ratio? It is the ratio of the parameters on model to its corresponding parameters on prototype. Okay, and it is denoted by the LR. Okay, there are three types of the similarities. First one is a geometric similarity. In that we discuss in that the length, width, depth, diameter, area, volume. Second one is the kinematic similarity, that is the velocity, acceleration. Third one is the dynamic similarity, that is the time, discharge, force, pressure, intensity, torque and power. Okay, so first, what is the geometric similarity? So the geometric similarity means what? If the ratio of corresponding length dimension in the model and prototype are equal, then geometric similarities exist. See, If the length of the model and the prototype is equal, then the geometric similarities exist. Okay? Like see here, for geometric similarity scale ratio, that is LR. LR is equals to LP upon LM is equals to BP upon BM, length, breadth and height. Height of LP means what? The length of prototype upon length of model. Breadth of prototype upon breadth of model, and then height of the prototype upon height of the model is equals to LR, where LR is the scale ratio. Okay, is equals to the AP upon M, area of prototype upon area of model, is equals to LR square, whereas volume of the prototype upon volume of model is equals to LR cube. Okay, this is called as the geometric similarities. Okay, so the next similarity is kinematic similarity. What is the kinematic similarities? If the ratio of the velocity and acceleration at the corresponding points in the model and at the corresponding points in the prototype are the same, then the kinematic similarities are exist. See, the ratio of the velocity and the acceleration at the corresponding points in the model and at the corresponding points in the prototype are the same, then the kinematic similarity are exist. When it is exist? When the velocity and acceleration in the both the prototype and the model is same. Okay, so here is the, it refers the similarities of the motion between the model and prototype. Okay, you can see here, that is a VP upon VN, that is the VR is the velocity ratio, VP means the volume of the prototype upon volume of the model, is equals to AP upon AM, where AR is the acceleration ratio. Okay, also the direction of the velocity in the model and prototype should be same. Okay, direction should also be same of the velocities in model and prototype. Okay, so that is called as the kinematic similarities. Okay, this is a VP means the velocity of the prototype upon velocity of the model is equals to VR, this is velocity ratio, and AP means acceleration of the prototype upon acceleration of the model is equals to AR, acceleration ratio. Okay, the next part is the dynamic similarities. So what is the dynamic similarities? It is the, if the ratio of the all the forces acting at the homologous points in the model and prototype is equal. Okay, there are the forces, that is the HM force, FPM force, V2 force, FPM force, FGM force. If these all forces are acting in the same point in the model and prototype is equal, then it is called as the dynamic similarities. Okay, you know, it refers the similarities of the masses and forces of the corresponding particles of the flow. Both geometric and kinematic similarities are prerequisite for the dynamic similarities, and the force is the vector quantity, so that not only ratio of the magnitude but also the direction should be parallel. Okay, so for dynamic similarities, force scale ratio is FR, that means FR means the force ratio, that is the force of the prototype upon force of the model. Okay, that is the force, inertia force, viscous force and gravity force at a point in a prototype, whereas the inertia force, viscous force and gravity force is corresponding point in the model. Okay, okay, so the next part of the laws is model laws. So what is the model laws? See, the what is model laws? The ratio of the corresponding forces which is acting at the corresponding points in the model and prototype should be equal for the dynamic similarity between the model and the prototype. Okay, what is the model law? See, the ratio of the corresponding force acting at the corresponding point in the model and the prototype should be equal for the dynamic similarities between the model and the prototype. Okay, this means that the dimensionless numbers should be same for the model as well as the prototype. Actually, it is very difficult to satisfy the condition that all dimensionless numbers are same for both model and prototype. Okay, so the models are designed on the basis of the force which is dominating in the flow situation. Okay, so the laws on which models are designed for the dynamic similarities are called as a model law or similarity law. What is model law? The law on which are designed for the dynamic similarities are called as the model law or the similarity law. There are the five types of the model laws. Now, first one is the Reynolds model law, second is the Frod model law, third is the Euler's model law, fourth is the Weber's model law, fifth is the Match model law. Okay? See that the first model law is the Reynolds model law. So, what is Reynolds model law? So, the law in which the models are based on Reynolds number is called as a Reynolds model law. Okay, that means what? Whenever the viscous force predominates over the inertia or other forces for dynamic similarities, the Reynolds number for the model must be equal to the Reynolds number for the prototype. Okay, so what are the application of the Reynolds model law? So the application of the Reynolds model law is for the pipe flow. Okay, flow in closed pipes, flow meters or the fans, etc. And the second application of the Reynolds model law is the flow around the immersed bodies like aeroplanes, submarines. Okay. Again, model law, Reynolds model law. Is it okay? The free surface flows, such as a flow over the spillways, vias, sluices, channels, flow up the jet from the orifice or nozzle where the waves are like to form on surface. It is the applications of the Reynolds model law. Okay. So second one is the Frod model law. Wait a minute. So what is the Frod model law? So, Frod model law is the law in which the models are based on the Frod numbers. It's called as a Frod model law. Whenever the gravity force are predominant over other forces for dynamic similarities. Okay. Okay, so Frod model law, application of the Frod model law is, it is used for the free surfaces flows, such as the flow over the spillways, vias, sluices, channels, the flow of the jet from one an orifice or nozzle where waves are likely to form on surface. Okay. In syllabus, you have only two types of example you have to solve. One is the Reynolds numbers and second one is the Frod model law numbers. Okay, there are some solved examples in book, so please refer that. Okay, third is the Euler model law. Euler model law is designed as a dynamic similarities, as called as the model laws or the laws of similarities. Whereas Euler's model law is applicable for the closed pipes in which the case turbulences is fully developed so that the viscous force are negligible and gravity force and surface tensions is absent. Okay. The next is the Weber's model law. So Weber's model law is designed for the dynamic similarities. There is a model law is applicable for the capillary rise in narrow passages, capillary movement of the water in soil, capillary waves in channels, and the flow over the vias for small heads. Okay, and the last is the Match model law. This is applicable for the flow of the aeroplanes and projectiles through the air of supersonic speed, that is the velocity more than the velocity of sound, aerodynamic testing, underwater testing of the torpedoes, and the water hammer problems. You can see here Reynolds model law, time scale ratio, that is the LT upon VR, AR is acceleration, scale ratio is VR upon TR, whereas acceleration is equals to velocity upon time, so L is equals to V upon T. Okay, and the velocity is equals to what? Length upon time, so T is equals to L upon V. This is the Reynolds model law. Here is one example related to the it is related to the model law, that is Reynolds model law. A pipe of diameter 1.5 meter is required to transport an oil of the specific gravity 0.90 and viscosity 3 into 10 raised to minus 2 poise at the rate of 3000 liters. So the tests were conducted on a 15 centimeter diameter pipe using water at 20 degrees Celsius. Find the velocity and the rate of flow in the model. Viscosity of the water at 20 degrees Celsius is equal to 0.01 poise. Okay. So first we have to convert it. The 300 liters is equal to meter cube. Okay, density of soil, specific gravity of the oil, Q for the prototype, all these given data. After that, using equation for the linear dimension, you can call by rate of the flow in prototype upon area of the prototype. Okay, this is all solved example. Okay, this problem you have to solve it in the home. Okay, so here our dimension analysis chapter is over. Okay, in next chapter we will discuss about the boundary layer theory. This is very important topic, boundary layer theory. Okay, we will discuss in the next lecture. Please give me your attendance in comment box. Okay, it is compulsory to you. Okay, the next is the Frodenham model law. You can see here this is the formula for Frodenham model law. This is Vm upon root Gm upon Lm. This is the velocity scale ratio. Is FRM is the scale ratio for the force, scale ratio for the pressure intensity, scale ratio for the power, that is LR raised to 3.5. Actually here is not shown properly, so I have write it here. Okay, the Frodenham model law. This is one example related to the Frodenham model law. Okay, so I have referred R.K. Bansal book for this unit. Okay, and some made-easy notes also. Okay, I have just giving you one formula related to this. Okay, thank you so much. Have a good day.